Introducing first, from Mexico City, Mexico, Furious Five! And here's the opponent, from Little Sicily, Andre Corino! Ladies and gentlemen, this is the opening contest here at Friday Night Fever. I am Kyle Malone, alongside Billy Ray, Joe Bob. You keep getting my name wrong. It's Billy Bob. There is no J. There's no Ray. There's nothing. I'm just Billy Bob. That's it. Get it right. I'm sorry about that, Billy Bob. Right now we have Furious V taking on Andre Corino in a qualifying match here for the CWO World Championship. One of these men will continue on in this tournament. Again, Brent the Ace Adelies needs to win the tournament in order to have his title reign actually recognized after he beat the Heavy Metal Machine at Fury. So, folks, we've got Furious 5, Andre Corino, really going at it right now. Furious 5 is going to lift him up and, oh, nice. Toss takedown. You know, I think you got the name of the move wrong. Oh, I'm not the best. Furious 5 with a couple of punches on to Andre Corino. He's going to lift him up into, oh, slamming him down with a gut wrench. You had that right. There's a backbreaker. You see, I got that one right. That was a double knee backbreaker. Andre Corino taking it to Furious 5. He's taking it to the man that looks like he came from like AAA, although I don't know. He looks like a glorified AAA guy, but at the same time, I don't know. He's got like the blonde hair. He's got like the whole purple outfit and everything. He's got like some sort of a theme going on. What is he, like one of them luchadors or something? I don't know if he's a luchador, but he's really taking it to Andre Corino right now. Andre Corino slid to the outside. Now he's back in, just meeting a couple of fists. Furious V's got him up. The headshot with it. With a takedown. Yeah, that's right. With the takedown. You don't even know what that's called. That's the takedown to you. You know, that was just an easy, you know, over the head, you know, shoulder thing. I don't know what that's called either, but you know what? And see, you just did the head wrench as well. See, I got it right that time. Oh my God. Are we going to sit here all night, like, arguing who knows the moves or who doesn't? Let's just focus on the match. Furious V is going to lift up Andre Corino into a suplex. Andre Corino's back looks like it's really hurting right about now. There it is with a belly-to-back, side belly-to-back suplex from Furious V on Andre Corino. Andre Corino might be out of it. Refs him. What? He's going for a one and then he lifts him up. What is going on with that? Andre Corino slowly getting up. Furious V just slams the head right back down into the mat. He's going for another cover. One, two. Oh, Andre Corino manages to kick out. Maybe Furious 5 shouldn't have lifted him up. Furious 5 laying some boots. You know, I really want to know, who do you think at this stage in the tournament, who do you think is going to walk out as the world champion?
You know, I think, in all honesty, I think it's going to be that monster red man. It's because he scares me, man. You know, everywhere he goes, there's always like somebody getting murdered or something, you know? I mean, I heard this one time they were down doing a pay-per-view in Florida. Wait a minute, Furious V! Wait a minute! No, he's got it up! Oh! Full Nelson slam! Referee's going to go in for the call! One! Two!
Your winner, Furious V! Following contest is scheduled for one fall. Introducing first, from Diamond City, Heather Diamond. And her opponent, she is the CWO Amazon Champion, an every man's dream, Archangel Sophie! Ladies and gentlemen, this is a non-title match between TRA and the Archangel Sophie. Falls count anywhere!
I don't know if it's false count anywhere. I don't think you read the sheet right. I think that's coming up later on.
Oh, hold on. No, I don't think it's... I don't think you're right. I think this is the false count anywhere match.
You know what? It doesn't matter. We're seeing a bunch of flubbering going on in the ring. That's right. They're all, like, flubbering. And it looks like Sophie actually changed her outfit, which it looks like she's in an evening gown. And, oh, yeah, that's my Sophie.
Now they're diving. Sonic Sophie into the corner. Bulldog!
Oh, don't ruin that pretty face. I don't want you to do that. You know, I heard Heather Diamond might actually have some sisters somewhere. I just can't remember exactly where they came from. Do you know anything about that? Because I think I'm going to have to, like, you know, look through my notes and do some little bit of research. Because Heather Diamond, I mean, that name just sounds so familiar to me right now.
You know, Billy Bob, I think you might be right, but I don't have the time to actually look it up because I'm concentrating on this match right here. Oh! Heather Diamond! Going up to the top rope! Sophie looks like she's down. Heather Diamond's getting top! And, oh, nice body splash! Gonna go for the cover. One, two, oh, Sophie kicks out. What a fighting champion.
That Heather Diamond, oh, man. You know, she's got, like, all them tattoos and stuff and that red hair, and she just looks like, you know, a vixen of some sort. I wonder what kind of a vixen she is.
What do you mean, what kind of a vixen? There's only one kind. Sophie with a nice Hurricane Rock takedown on Heather Diamond.
Lay in the boots. Fans.
Just so everyone is on the same page, when it comes to the Archangel Sophie, she is not the most winningest champion here in the CWO, but she has that strap around her waist. She's lost more matches than she's won, but when it boils down to, when that title's on the line, she's only lost one match with the title on the line.
Yeah, that's why I love Sophie. And they're doing some flubbering. Oh, whoa, look at that. There's woman-on-woman action. I love that stuff.
Heather Diamond's just waiting on Sophie to get up. She's really taking it to the Archangel Sophie right now. Oh, look at that. Suplex. Gonna go for the cover. Ah, no. Sophie was right there, right next to the ropes.
Do you know what kind of suplex that was?
It looked like some sort of a T-bone.
You might be right. Might have to look at the replay on that. Heather Diamond, no! Do not ruin my Sophie's head!
Someone's coming down to the ring. We don't know why. Randomness from WWE. I don't know why they even come and bother on our shows. Wait, Heather Diamond's gonna go for a cover! One, two...
Ladies and gentlemen, here is your winner, Heather Diamond. Ladies and gentlemen, the following contest is scheduled for one fall. It is a qualifying round in the CWO World Championship Tournament. Introducing first, Chase Silver. His opponent, making his way from Dublin, Ireland, he is the CWO Extreme Champion, Red Mantis.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is another qualifying match in the CWO World Championship Tournament between Chase Silver and Red Mantis.
Oh my God, no! No, you see, as I was saying earlier, this is what I was talking about. You know, I heard right before Red Mantis came out to the ring that there was, like, you know, they found another dead body. And, you know, when it comes to Red Mantis, like, I heard he was performing for an indie that was, well, I wouldn't say an indie, but they were pretty good. They were called, like, the CWE. Yeah, that's right, the CWE. And he was down there. And Red Mantis, like, you know, they at this hotel they were all staying at, and there was, like, you know, this happened, like, twice, I think. There was, like, over 10 dead bodies that they found. And Red Mantis was involved in that show that weekend. He was, like, a big pay-per-view, too. He kills people, I swear to God.
I don't know if that rumor's true, because he was never found guilty of anything. They could never find any evidence. But now, Red Manis looks like he's going to take Chase Silver. He's going to go old school. Walking that top rope and, oh, right down onto Chase Silver.
Red Manis is definitely a dangerous man. You know, I definitely don't want to be near him at all. And yet, being this close to him just freaks me out, man. I really hope he wins this tournament, so that way, you know, he's got my back.
Big boot from Red Manis on the Chase Silver. Red Manis does not look like he's done. He is definitely a monster when it comes to the ring. And being in the ring, he is currently the CWO Extreme Champion, but he is also a former CWO World Television Champion, as I'm reading my notes here. That's right. He's going to go for a cover. Whoa. 2, 3, oh no, no! Chase Silver kicked out right at the very last second. Red Manis now does not look happy about that. He's gonna taunt Chase Silver. What's he gonna do? He's gonna walk. Tombstone pile driver on the Chase Silver.
He calls that the Dublin loving.
You just made that up. 1, 2.
Ladies and gentlemen, here is your winner, Red Mantis.
Ladies and gentlemen, again, there was a dead body found just outside the arena. I don't know, but I'm really scared of that Red Mantis. He better win.
Welcome back to Friday Night Fever. I am Kyle alongside Billy Bob, and this is yet another first round qualifying tournament match to determine who will be the new CWO World Champion. Again, Brent the Ace Adelaide won the title off of the Heavy Metal Machine Logan and decided to pretty much relinquish the belt. Although the CWO World Championship Committee, or the Title Championship Committee, not World Championship, sorry folks, the Championship Committee is saying that if Brent the Ace Adelaide can win the tournament, they will recognize his championship title reign. However, if he can't, they will announce that the title was vacated during this period.
Oh, man, you know, that's got to suck for Brent. I mean, you know, you got Sean Hurl and you got Young Lee, and these two guys, I mean, they're young, they're new to the CWO, they're new to the wrestling scene, and one of these two, man, I mean, they surely are championship material, but when they got to face off against like guys like Red Manis, Brent the Ace Allies, Blake Hale, Furious 5 Hardcore, you know, these guys, I mean, you've got all these other really good talents who are, like, established. And it's going to be really hard for me to just decide, you know, who is it that's going to walk out of here as a champion. And so, but I'm putting my money on Red Manis. That's just where it is. Red Manis, you call it.
I'll tell you what, if you're wrong, you owe me $50.
You know what? Hold on. I'm going to take that back. I'm going to wait. I'm going to wait just a bit because I don't want to pay you $50.
You're just a little cheapskate.
Yeah, that's right. You know, I wouldn't say it's cheap, but you want to put a bet on it, and I don't want to pay you. That's just how it is, Kyle. You know,
Sean Earl, Young Lee, Young's fighting back. Oh, nice! Step up, Insigari. Someone away in the arm, Sean Earl.
You know, one of these guys. One of these two, like I said, deserves a world championship, but I don't know, again, against the people they have to face. I'm willing to bet that the next TV champion is going to be, you know, the winner of this match is probably going to end up being the next TV champion, just so you watch.
Yeah, that's right, the current, not the ferns.
Yeah, you see, you're all blubbering now, you're like blah, 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 blah.
Now, will you stop it? Okay, the next TV champion is going to be one of these two men. I swear to God. It's either going to be Sean LaHurl or it's going to be Young Lee.
You know, I don't think I can agree with that. Although, it's very much possible.
Young Lee now with a nice... Oh, what was that? Young Lee from Tokyo, Japan.
He's not from Tokyo. I mean, did you know how to spell his name? He's from, you know, Beijing. Or somewhere in China. I don't know exactly.
another moonsault right on top of Sean Hurl. This Young Lee, he is really agile. We don't have a cruiserweight championship, but if we did, Young Lee might be a cruiserweight champion. Sean Hurl now taking it. European uppercut. Gonna take him down. Spinal kick to the back. Looks like he's kicking a soccer ball. Got him. Oh my God! That could make it so that Young Lee could never have kids. Sean Hurl's gonna drag him into the middle of the ring. He's setting him up. Off the ropes. Oh, step up, Insigiri. He looks like he's really going for it here. Oh, a moonsault of his own. Look at that. You know, Sean Hurl, you know, I mean, this guy, he's got some good skills. He could make it in the tournament. Sean Hurl, Young Lee, looks like it with a European uppercut of his own. He's going to try to take it to Sean Hurl. What's he going to do? Oh, sit up powerbomb. Could this be it? Young Lee going up to the top rope. Oh, spinning body splash. He's going to go for the cover. Could this be it? One, two.
Ladies and gentlemen, here is your winner, Young Lee.
Folks, we have to take another commercial break after this match. Coming up next, we have Dr. Bill versus Jeff the Killer. We'll be right back.
Ladies and gentlemen, the following contest is scheduled for one fall and is a qualifying match in the CWO World Championship. Introducing first, from the surgery, Dr. Bill
looks like he's definitely ready for battle, and he's quite bloody. You know, what do you think he's a doctor in?
You know, I don't know what he could be a doctor in, but I wouldn't be too surprised if somebody woke up in, like, some sort of a seedy motel with, like, you know, stitches and a spleen removed or something. Man, this guy's kind of scary, but not quite.
And his opponent, Jeff the Killer.
Folks, we will be right back as this match will continue after this quick commercial break. Welcome back to Friday Night Fever. I am Cameron alongside Billy Bob, and this is another qualifying match in the CWO World Heavyweight Championship Tournament. One of these two men will continue on and possibly face Brent the Ace Allies for the CWO World Heavyweight Championship if Brent can make it all the way. Now, Dr. Bill and Jeff the Killer have quite some animosity because Dr. Bill blames Jeff the Killer for not being able to win a single tag team match while they were together.
You know what, Kyle? I don't know if it's because of Jeff getting pinned all the time or if it was just because of the fact that they're teamed together, but it didn't seem quite right. He's going for a cover. And, no, Dr. Bill somehow got out of Jeff the Killer. But, I mean, you know what? Jeff the Killer, I mean, he's got something going on, but I just can't quite put my finger on it. I don't know. Is it like, you know, an internet meme? Maybe a YouTube thing? Or, you know, like a website or something like that where he's originated? I don't know. Can you enlighten us a little bit on that?
Didn't I just tell you? Dr. Bill is going to lay the boots to Jeff the Killer.
I know you just said something. I'm going to have to watch the replay.
Dr. Bill going after Jeff the Killer again. He's not happy with Jeff the Killer at all. The two of them have been at boots ever since Money in the Bank, when the tag team decided to, well, ever since Dr. Bill got rid of the tag team and then gave up the opportunity to be in the CWO world. Oh my God, that had to hurt. They gave up being
in the CWO World Tag Team Ladder Match, in which, after that happened, we had to find a quick replacement, in which case the Broken Hardys came out, and I'm sure Jeff the Killer and Dr. Bill are both salty about that one.
Oh, yeah, I can guarantee you somebody's not happy. Dr. Bill looking like he's gonna... Oh!
That had to hurt! He taunted Jeff the Killer and then came off the ring straight onto Jeff the Killer on the barricade. He's gonna run back into the ring with Jeff the Killer. Again, one of these two men will continue on in the CWO World Heavyweight Championship Tournament. Who are they gonna face in the next rounds? Folks, the brackets have not been set up yet. They're setting up all the qualifying matches right now. Everybody who qualifies will advance into the first quarterfinal match, in which case the brackets will then be determined as Dr. Bill takes it to Jeff the Killer.
Oh yeah, Jeff looks like he's kind of hurting a little bit. Dr. Bill's just trying to really just take that aggression out on him. I wonder whose kidney he took out.
You know, Jeff the Killer and Dr. Bill, both these men have what it takes to be in the CWO, but one and only one will be able to continue on. Dr. Bill now looking to set up and get ready to take out Jeff the Killer. He's waiting for Jeff to get up. Jeff looks like he's really hurting here.
You know, Dr. Bill, Jeff the Killer, I mean, can't you guys just get along? You were great as a tag team working together.
Nice fisherman buster from Dr. Bill onto Jeff the Killer. He's not going to go for a cover.
No, he looks like he's kind of pissed off, and Jeff's going to set him up for something.
No, Jeff was not able to hit it. Dr. Bill got on the move. He's going to set up Jeff now with a powerbomb into a pin. Referee's going for the cover. One, two. Oh, no, wait a minute. Now he's going to turn over into a Boston Crab. Dr. Bill trying to lay the pain into Jeff the Killer. No, Jeff's got to fight off. He's like right there, right under the ropes. No, he's going to fight out of it. And he was right next to the ropes.
Jeff the Killer's got a brain, you know. Just give you a heads up. He's got quite the brain.
Jeff the Killer going to set Dr. Bill into the corner. Now he's going to bring him up to the top rope. What is Jeff going to do? Uh-oh. Reverse suplex! That was a reverse superplex. Get it right. He's going to go for a cover. Referee going in for the count. One, two.
Here is your winner, Jeff the Killer.
Ladies and gentlemen, this is the next contest in the CWO World Championship Tournament in the qualifying match. We have the Heavy Metal Machine taking on Anthony the Kid.
Oh, that Heavy Metal Machine, man. You know, I kind of feel his pain. You know, he was the World Heavyweight Champion.
Was. But did he actually win the World Heavyweight Championship, as Brett the Ace Allies is trying to prove right now? He wants to know who it was that the Heavy Metal Machine beat in order to win the CWO World Championship and become a 5-time CWO World Champion.
But you know what? I'm almost guessing that maybe Brent's is kind of a little salty, which is why he wants this to take place in the first place, because I was at that tournament. I paid my ticket to go to it. He beat some guy, I can't remember his name though, but he beat him and won the world championship. And throughout his career, you know, he's beat a lot of people, including Brent the Ace Allies.
I don't know about that one.
Oh yeah, I think he beat him.
Logan trying to set him up. He's gonna go for a neck whip on Anthony the Kid. I do not think Anthony the Kid is gonna have what it takes to win this match. However, if Anthony can somehow pull out all the stops, he might be able to beat, oh, Stunner from the Heavy Metal Machine. He might be able to beat Logan in this match if he can pull out all the stops, because he is facing a 20-time World Heavyweight
Champion. That is right, folks. The Heavy Metal Machine Logan is the only 20-time World Heavyweight Champion in professional wrestling history as he takes on Anthony the Kid. Anthony trying to get up. Heavy Metal Machine's got him. He's going to knock him down. Wait a minute. He kicks him in the gut. Oh, my God. It's Death's Edge right on Anthony the Kid. Just throwing him across the ring like he doesn't care about his life at all. Going for the cover. One, two. Anthony somehow kicks out of that. Logan must be getting old at his age.
Oh, yeah, because he likes to bill himself as like being like 4,000 some odd plus years old, but no, I almost don't want to believe that.
He's going to go for a cover again. One, two, oh.
Oh, my God. Anthony somehow kicked out again. I mean, yeah, look at Anthony, though. I mean, you see the outfit that he's got on? He looks like some sort of, like, you know, Mortal Kombat kind of rip-off dude. Because he's got, like, you know, that ski mask thing going on. He's got, like, pinkish, fuchsia-looking, like, along with green. I mean, the colors just don't match, you know. And he's got red on his elbow pads. The colors definitely don't match. I really hope that we don't see much of Anthony the Kid.
Logan just fell over in the ring. With a nice running DDT on Anthony Kidd. He's going to lift him up again.
I mean, Anthony looks like he's some sort of a cyborg, maybe. Is that what he's trying to be? Or is he just, you know, some, like, you know, kid?
Oh, no. Well, the Heavy Metal Machine really looks like he's about ready to take it to Anthony the Kid. Going to send him into the corner. Could he be setting up? There it is. Looks like he's really going to take Anthony the Kid right now. With that reverse fireman's driver, which he likes to call the Singularity. Oh, my God. Let's take a look at that one more time. Oh. And there it is again. Heavy Metal Machine going to go in after hitting the Singularity. I don't think Anthony can get up. One, two, three.
Here's your winner, the Heavy Metal Ladies and gentlemen, the following contest is scheduled for one fall. It's for the CWO Television Championship. In this corner, the challenger, the Ripper. And his opponent, he is the CWO World Television Champion. The leader of the force, Hardkore.
Ladies and gentlemen, here is your winner, Hardkore!